morning, good morning. How y'all doing? Thank God for gracing us to see another Lord's Day. It is indeed a privilege to be here today. As I sat this morning and you know, listening to service and listening to reading of the scripture, my heart rejoiced this morning. I am enthused this morning. My soul has been refreshed. And the psalmist says that what we need to do is turn it over to Him. That's the Lord, and it says that He will see you through. And I think that that is correct. Last week we were talking about the correct source. The Bible says it is full of Him, it's through Him, and it's to Him, all things. It says, to whom be glory to Him. And I think one of the things that we need to do as believers, all of our trials and tribulations, obstacles that we're going through, and we all are going through something. Let that be known this morning. We all are going through something. There is not one of us who has the right to say or can acknowledge that we are not going through something, because we are. But it's all about how we look at things. It is our perspective. If you're looking at life through divine perspective, your outlook is going to be bright, regardless of the circumstances. If you're looking at life through the eyes of greed and doom and destruction and all of that, then I dare say your outlook is going to be bleak today. So I think one of the things that we need to do, it is a resource that we don't utilize enough. That is our Creator. We need to make sure we remember Him in the days of our youth. Because we are growing now to Him. We are getting older and older. And through that course of life, I begin to learn and find out for myself. You know, it's easy to say a thing than it is to do it. But I am learning how to live in this devil's world as an older individual. When we get older, we have different responsibilities. We are certainly the same as far as accountability is concerned. We all are accountable to God. But as far as our responsibility though, they do change in a different method, structure-wise, as far as how we carry out our life circumstances. Whether or not we're going to run and hide from our situations, or will we face them with the proper motivation, face them through the provision and outlook and care and love of the Word of God. Do we choose to tuck tail and run and hide and be in denial and say, woe to me, you know, all of these things is happening to me. But that's just life. And in life, we all are going to suffer persecution. We are going to suffer trials and tribulations. You don't have to do anything wrong to suffer. We must learn this, but it is all for our learning. It is all for the provision, as far as God's word is concerned, in making us just like Him. God knows exactly what needs to happen in all of our lives. He turns the heat up, He turns it down. He knows when it's necessary to do so, to strengthen us, to encourage us, and to make us just like Him. So, we talked about last week, the source. This week, we want to talk about keeping your word. We'll talk about keeping your word. And I know that there's many layers to this. And this probably put many of us, our minds, in a tailspin, because it's obviously unlimited. But the various avenues we can take in this message. But But I want us to look at this from a divine perspective. We're going to go to the Old Testament, and we're going to start at First Chronicles, the 17th chapter. And we're going to read these verses this morning, and I want you to read them for yourself. Because this is going to set the stage. This is going to be the undergirding of the message this morning. Keeping your word. Now in 1 Chronicles chapter 17, starting at the 16th verse. Then David the king went in and sat before the Lord and said, "Who am I, O Lord God? And what is my house that you have brought me this far? This was a small thing in your eyes, O God, but you have spoken of your servant's house for a great while to come, and have regarded me according to the standard of a man of high degree, O Lord God. What more can David still say to you concerning the honor bestowed on your servant? For you know your servant, O Lord, for your servant's sake. According to your own heart, you have wrought all this greatness to make known all these great things. Lord, there is none like you. Neither is there any God besides you. According to all that we have heard, my ears, and that one nation in the earth is like your people Israel, whose God went to redeem for himself as a people to make you a name by great and terrible things, and driving out nations from before your people, whom you redeemed out of Egypt. For your people Israel, you made your own people forever. You said, and you, O Lord, became their God. Now, O Lord, let the word that you have spoken concerning your servant and concerning his house be established forever. And do as you have spoken. Let your name be established and magnified forever, saying, the Lord of hosts is the God of Israel, even a God to Israel, and the house of David, your servant, is established before you. For you, O my God, have revealed to your servant that you will build for him a house. Therefore, your servant has found courage to pray before you. Now, O Lord, you are God, and have promised this good thing to your servant. And now, it has pleased you to bless the house of your servant, that it may continue forever before you. For you, O Lord, have blessed it, is blessed forever. God is a keeper of his word. And this stems from the Davidic covenant. This is the covenant that God made with David, his servant, concerning his people, the nation of Israel. I want you to turn to 2 Chronicles, the 6th chapter, verses 12 through 15. This is a continuation. This is Solomon, David's son. It says, then he stood before the altar of the people in the presence of all the assembly of Israel and spread out his hands. Now Solomon had made a bronze platform 5 cubits long, 5 cubits wide, 3 cubits high, and had set it in the midst of the court. And he stood on it, kneeled on his knees in the presence of all the assembly of Israel, and spread out his hands towards heaven. He said, O Lord, the God of Israel, there is no God like you in heaven or on earth, keeping covenant, keeping his word, and showing love and kindness to your servants who walk before you with all their heart, who has kept with your servant David, my father, that which you have promised him, indeed you have spoken with your mouth and have fulfilled it with your hand, as it is this day.